Hey guys, so it's happened. Jake Paul vs. Andre August happened last night. I ended up passing out straight after the Cruz versus DuVern fight, I think it was. I ended up passing out after that fight, like straight after it. So I did miss this. The only thing I know about this is actually, let's not spoil it. For anyone who doesn't know what happened last night, get ready. I mean, the title is going to be a spoiler itself. So let's get straight into it and let's react to it because I have no idea. Luckily, this is footage from somewhere else. So it's not a DAZN footage. So technically, DAZN, fuck off. Yeah. Right. Let's go. Okay. Let's get straight into it. Jake Paul, obviously, this is knockout. We all know there was a knockout. As you can see, it's a very short video. So it happens in round number one. And let's see how this happens. I'm gonna turn this down a bit. Actually, no, we're gonna have it on. All right. So, Jake's team, obviously right in front of us. That is an MVP cameraman for Jake Paul. When I've seen these shorts before, Andre August is wearing shorts that I've seen before. Now, the first thing I noticed about Jake, look at it. He's got a bit of bounce to him this time. He's got more bounce. People are going, "Oh, Jake's imitating KSI's karate style." No, he's not. No, he's not. KSI doesn't have the backhand up and has the front hand moving. He used to, which was in the, what fight was that? That was the first fight. The Joe Fournier fight. He done that. And then but he only done it a little bit and then he had the hands down stuff. Yeah. Nah. So I wouldn't say Jake's copying or imitating or anything like this. Anyone who says this fighter's copying this fighter, they're normally wrong. But there is a few, like, because obviously you're going to try and want to copy the best. So a lot of them try and copy Floyd. A lot of them try and copy Tyson Fury. You know, a lot of them try and copy Muhammad Ali because they're the best and they're trying to understand why they're the best. So let's get straight into it. So I like what I see from here from Jake. I'm not a huge fan. I like this, right? It means Andre August needs to be very cautious because Jake Paul is just following his head. All times, this hand is following his head and body. It's like, all right, cool. He's just basically making sure this arm is also a range finder. Jake, I feel like he's using this as a range finder right now. He's holding it out to see where he is. Like, if he's in range, he could catch him. I don't like how he sits down, though. He literally sits down like he's about to sit on a chair. Andre August, come on. You've boxed before. Why are you sitting down like it's a chair? Andre August throws a feint. Jake reacts to the feint. He backs up. Jake throws like a faint hook, but it was more like a real hook that just didn't land. Jake threw the hook in a weird way. He didn't just like show it with his body. He threw it basically. So I thought it was a bit weird. Well, I say I thought. I haven't even seen this. That's quite nice. Jake's using jabs there. The ref got in the way, so I can't tell if any of that landed. Good jab from Jake. Jake's just jabbing. Jake keeps his head on the center line at all times. I'm noticing this. This head doesn't move. It's bah, bah, bah. It's here. It's always on the same line. It's like, bro. I don't know what happened here. I want to see what happened here. So he kind of went in. Jake threw a hook, didn't he? Jake threw a hook that missed. Good head movement from Andre August there. Rolls it. I think he rolled it. It might have just slipped. But he tried to, I think he tried to roll it and went in. And Jake ties him up, as Jake should do. Don't let him work the body. Don't let him work on the inside. It's good from Jake. I'm like, honestly, yeah. Jake's just toying with him. Just, he's basically seeing what he can do. That's what Jake's doing. He's seeing what he can do. As you can see, Jake's now got the glove on his chin. A lot of fighters do this. They have the glove here, and it's ready to just throw out. I wish Jake Paul would have more head movement to have this kind of stance. Because when he gets, obviously he wants to go, he wants to build up to get a championship belt. You can't have this stance if you can't move your head. Because they will just catch you every single time. Like, Andre August here. Step in with the jab. Step in with a jab. Maybe slip off to the side, throw a hook. Feint something and then throw an uppercut. Because that would be Jake Paul's biggest weakness. In my opinion, Jake Paul's biggest weakness would be an uppercut. because he keeps his head here, so it'll just go up and down. And if he goes down into the uppercut while you're coming up, oof. Yeah, he leans over with this shot. Look at that. Uppercut right there. Bang. You step in with the backhand uppercut, you catch him and he's gone. Because Jake has no balance in that position there. That's a good jab from Andre August. Didn't really do much, but Jake jabs back. Yeah, see, Jake's just jabbing. And if you notice, Andre August turns his head. Jake's jabbing that, which is still hitting him in the face. And he's can't really see what's coming. Jake goes down to the body. That was good from Jake. Oh, Jake tries to tie up. And also pivot at the same time. Good shots from Jake there. Jake's now going to know that this guy's just going to duck his head. Jake should know now. This guy's just coming in to duck his head. Send in an uppercut. You've got to send in an uppercut. You know he's going to get in too close. You've got to send in the uppercut when he dives. Oh, Jake got cool there. But I think Andre August also got cool. I didn't get to see the Andre August bit. So he said put it on him. Nah, Andre August was off balance. And he threw a massive one that caught Jake. Jake did not like that one. Andre's covering up. Oh. I feel like August doesn't have the right stance for him. Every fighter has their own stance. Now, the reason why... The way people have their own stance is the way that works best for them, you know? I just feel like this stance doesn't work very well with Andre August. I feel like he's just getting caught too much in this stance. I feel like he needs a different stance, or he just needs to improve on certain things. I don't know what the fuck this is. This I don't like. It's like he moves with his front foot and leaves the back foot where it is, but also goes down, and it's like you are off balance. You're basically doing what Gibb did. You know, we don't want that. Yeah, Andre August also has zero head movement. I said this a few videos ago. Andre August has no head movement. This head just stayed on the center line at the same time as Jake. Look, neither of them are just, like, when they're just standing there, they're literally just standing there like this, moving their arms a bit. Neither of them are bobbing side to side, bobbing and weaving, slipping, rolling, nothing. If I'm standing still, I'm making sure I'm breathing, but also moving, because if I stand still for a second, my opponent's gonna be like, all right, cool, you stood still, cool, yeah. And if you don't switch it up as well, if you just bob and weave, or if you just slip and roll, say if you're just rolling the whole time, they're just gonna wait for you to roll one way, and then bang, that's it. Cool, Andre there. Andre August has fear. Yeah, look at that. You see that roll there? He kind of like half rolled and went back up. He kind of half rolled, rolled back the other way, went back up. Now he's going in. Jake should land an uppercut there. Now the head movement's there. But he doesn't use it as much. He doesn't use it in an effective way. Oh, clean! Uppercut is nasty from Jake. He brings it all the way down though. That's my only issue, is it? He does. Oh, actually, maybe no. He does. Oh, no, he half pulls it down. He pulls it where you should and then sends it back up. I'd love to see on the broadcast where that actually landed, because obviously I can't watch any of the broadcast because it's copyrighted and DAZN really don't like me using their stuff. But oh, sends him down. That was clean, yeah. Jake then waved at him. He done that and saying goodbye. Yeah, I mean, oh, fair play. Oh, Andre August can't. No. Nah. That fight should have been called when he dropped. That fight shouldn't have even had a count. Look at how he drops, bro. Don't get me wrong, Tyson Fury's been dropped in the same way and got back up. Tyson Fury's been dropped like this before. Not like, oh, this exact same shot and everything like that. It's he dropped, fell on his back. You saw his eyes were open, he breathed. But it's the way they also get back up. Look at how Fury gets back up compared to a bunch of these guys. These guys are trying to rush it. They're like, oh, let me get back up quickly. And then they're stumbling. Fury took the 8 count, stood back up slowly, took his time to get up. He didn't just rush up when he had to get up. He took his time, breathed, and then the ref was like, you good? And he went, yeah. And then he went on to draw that fight, I think, that one. I think that was the second one where he drew. But if not, it was the first one where he won. That was clean. I like that. I like that. So, does this prove anything? Not really. It shows that Jake Paul has experience. It shows that Jake Paul knows what he's doing. It shows that Jake Paul has an amateur level of understanding boxing. So that's pretty good. You know, he's still got far to go before he gets a belt. Before he even touches or even looks at a belt. He has so long to go. Because that isn't a belt level performance. But that was pretty good. So fair play to Jake for that one. Nothing I can really bash him for. You know, there's a few things here and there that he needs to work on. Head movement, fainting. He needs to work on fainting a bit more. You know, I feel like his hook feints, they waste energy. You know, if you're going to faint a hook, just twist the body a little bit. Maybe, like, show it a little bit. I liked what Jake did against Tyron Woodley in the second one, where he would turn the glove. People went, oh, that's clearly a signal to get knocked out. No, what I believe Jake done was, he was doing this, Tyron Woodley went, all right, he ain't going to use that for a bit, because he's just, maybe he's hurt it or something, and then Jake's thrown it. And it catches Woodley and Woodley goes out. That is one of the feints that I love from Jake. I feel like that's his best feint he's ever come out with. But that's all I've really got time for today. Because we got to go react to another video. And then we've got UFC tonight. And I will be doing a video tomorrow. Hopefully I don't pass out for that. But guys, let me know where you think I'm wrong. Let me know where you think I'm right. Let me know what you think. And let me know who you think Jake fights next. I don't see Jake going after like a big name just yet. I see it being one or two more bums. No disrespect to anyone, but that's what Jake's really after right now, so he can build up. Like, that's what normal boxers do. When they start, they fart off bums and then they build up. No disrespect, but that's just what they are. They're taxi drivers. But apart from that, hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out, everyone.